Hey everybody, welcome back to my Swallow Territory episode. This is the Man of Steel episode, and I'm not gonna speak much today. I'm not really in a good mood today, to be honest, but yeah. I'm just gonna do like 15 minutes about this thing, just letting us know. I feel like this film's really underrated in a way. I feel like Man of Steel really had a lot of great moments within itself. And I feel like it was a really great way to sort of the DCEU, and also the fact that there's a lot of characters that really they're all prominent today really show here, such as General Zod and also Clark's parents and Superman's dad, which is the same person, which is three people, but not to even to Block. It really had a lot of something that I really liked, how the film has dealt with its stuff at the day. The film really focuses on the main character and also the plot as well, and also the fact that there was a lot of things today. They got right with how Superman is supposed to be, and I think why people don't like the film is because of they are like, you see Superman being really destructive, and it looks like he was like, it's like every time Superman was trying to save people, he was trying to end up making it look like it made things worse, and the fact that that's what, but most of the DCU fans, they see him as doing it for a little purpose and for a reason, and like, this is way how. You know, in the comic books and also in the cartoons and stuff like that, Superman causes all this destruction, and also but when it comes to the film, it's a little bit questionable, because I feel like most of the audience has like expectations for how they want Superman to be, but what they have to understand is that's not his film, this is the way how he wants. Which want Superman to be portrayed, and also the fact that Superman is doing this it looks like realistic in a way. One of the most important things in this film was when Clark was growing up, we see him like, involved like with our children when his age, and also the fact that scene where he saved the children from the bus, I feel like it was really necessary for him to do so, because I feel like that's one way to made the character squander emotionally to the point where it needed to be done. Because I feel like the one time when in the future when Superman when Clark had to let his father Jonathan die, it really it shows that he learned how to protect him, not protect his secret identity, but the fact that he had to. I feel like the world wasn't ready for Superman to save the world, the day type thing yet, and that's something that he did when he was a little kid with the bus, and also I feel like it was also necessary when he saved the guys in the oil rig. I really like the main villain inside. I feel like he was also, he had a little purpose and a mission to do what he wanted to do, because I feel like he was really useful. He did useful things, even he cared about Krypton, just like Superman. That's also the fact that he just wanted Superman to understand how he really feels and all these things, and then the fact that he's sometimes thought well over his head, sometimes, so that's. Well, there's a little bit of a difference between him and Clark, is that he, that Superman, really, he wants a little bit both. He wants to be, Superman, and he also wants to be Clark, and at the same time, it really makes sense of how he wants to be portrayed, and how he wants to role see him as. I like Lois Lane in this film. She was really useful in the film when she got a chance to, when it comes to her saving My drummer's still here helping Superman. I liked Amy Adams' portrayal of her. I feel like she did a really great job. I also liked watching Superman interact with Martha. And because I feel like she was really, she really cares about Clark, and she cares about what happens to him, and that's something that is really useful for him. I feel like that she was somebody that Clark really needed. It's kind of interesting to think about doing that of the Dark Zero event thing, and the ending that Bruce Wayne is somewhere in Metropolis. But yeah, that was insane. I will talk about Batman v Superman next week. Just need us now. The part where Superman snapped his Azar's neck. I feel like the fact that he did that, I feel like it was really necessary for him to do so, because he had to make a choice. He had to let him live and cross destruction, or he had to post up to this, and he had to jump to this person from Krypton, and that's a really risky thing that Superman had to do. So he had to do what he had to do, because I feel like it was really, it needed to be done. And also, he didn't really tell when Superman was coming, that he was, obviously didn't tell that Superman's upset, but also the fact that it's really nice seeing that Lois Lane was, also saw him, and saw him do that, and not seeing him do that, but being there and comforting, being a comfort to Superman when it happened. She tried to fast, it was like, she walked there for like a minute or so from where she saw Superman flying up, then Superman inside the building. She went fast. The way Superman fought in this film was really something that we haven't seen before. Else, the fact that he shows how powerful he really is, and the fact that he wants to, but also the fact that he is useful. He's on the good side, and that's something else that they bring up later on in Batman v Superman. For example, they asked him, they wonder if he's the bad guy or not, but the fact that he can cause so much destruction if he really chooses to, and the fact that he doesn't means that there's a lot of good within him. I think that Henry Cavill really portrayed him really well. I feel like he really understood how he wanted to, I feel like he understood how Superman is supposed to be, and also how he understood the character's journey within the film, and I feel like there's a lot of things that he has done to make Superman really better than ever, because I feel like it was really, the film really made things see Superman and also superheroes in a different way of how powerful they really could be, especially towards the fans. So yeah, that's pretty much all I have to say right now. So yeah, I really feel that there's a lot of things that storytellers can learn from this film. The fact that there's a character who is like lost, who's lost and is trying to find his way to who he wants to be, and that's all the fact that he's still finding out what he wants, it doesn't mean it's just because he's not, his journey isn't completed, it doesn't mean that it's a bad day. And I feel like there's a lot of things that Superman is trying to do that for himself, that he wants to understand himself, and that's something that I find fascinating about the Man of Steel. But this is it for today's episode. Hope you guys enjoyed my review on it. I feel like this wasn't really much talked about right now, but yeah, I'll talk more about him doing Batman v Superman, all that stuff. So yeah, thank you so much for watching or listening. You can subscribe right here, and also watch a video right here, and I'll see you guys soon. Bye.